And we are back, gearing up for match number two of the day. This is the Call of Duty Championship presented by Xbox, the biggest tournament of the year for all of our Call of Duty players. Hastro, so excited to get this one started. Complexity versus Real All-Stars.
Yeah, it's going to be a great one. You know, the first match that we saw that S&D get pulled by, you know, the French side.
Vitality Returns went big in that.
And so, you know, SB ran those run-and-gun game types. Let's see if Europe can actually bring one home here versus Complexity. This would be a huge upset if they managed to do it.
Yeah, Complexity, arguably the number one squad in the world. They're looking to have a hot start to the day. We'll see if they can get it started in just a moment. But right now, let's go down on the floor with Justine.
All right, we're down here on the main stage floor. Now behind us, the teams are getting ready to play. Now this is going to be a great matchup. We have Complexity, who was usually number one in all of these tournaments. But guess what? This is a big game for them. This is their first one of the day, so I'm super excited to see how all this is all going. And I've been reading your tweets on Twitter, so make sure you guys are tweeting us, and we will keep you posted throughout the game. So hopefully this will start soon, and I hope you guys are looking forward to it. Back up to you guys at the booth.
Pretty awesome that you can tweet to us now.
Yeah, Twitter's a great tool. Yep. Use Twitter and tweet at us all weekend long. Use the hashtag CODChamps, and we'll be able to read all sorts of information coming from you guys, some feedback and what you think about the matches.
Yeah, I want to get some predictions here. Like, first of all, who wins game one? It's going to be Blit, or it's going to be Domination, a respawn game mode. And then the second part of that question is, which player is going to have most kills? Who is the most influential slayer in that game? Because you have a stacked lineup for Complexity. Crim6, Karma, TP, Aches, any of those guys could top the leaderboard.
Yeah, and that's something, you know, we've seen in the past. You know, let's say TP, for example, is known to be like the lesser kind of slaying player on that team, more objective-oriented.
Right.
But, you know, let's say like an MLG Columbus, the guy went off, and he was slaying, you know, in the slaying department, he was pretty much leading Complexity in the slaying department. And that's,
I think that was a shocker for everyone.
Yeah, but
they're,
you know,
like, wait, this guy only ran the bomb and did the selfless stuff in Black Ops 2 and Call of Duty Ghost. He's a monster.
Right, absolutely. But, you know, he went into regionals. He didn't have the best slaying performance there. And, you know, Complexity kind of stumbled and they lost to SB there. And so they actually have the number two seed coming out of the U.S. here. But, you know, you're right. Any of those players can go off at any time. Some of them are just electric, and when they catch fire, a player like Karma, whenever he goes off and he gets in the zone, he's unstoppable. And that's what we have to look out for here. Crim6 is just one of those guys who's consistently amazing. On your screen there, you just saw Aches. Aches is a longtime veteran who's won multiple championships. He's a veteran player who can just come in at any time. He's also very consistent.
One of the most fierce competitors out there as well. Aches hates losing more than he loves winning. Same thing goes for Karma.
I think that's
the motto of this Complexity squad. They don't really care about championships, titles, monies. They care about beating everyone else and just showing that they will not lose to the other competitors on this field. Of course, they want what they get at the end of the tournament. It's not about the shine for them, though. It's all about demoralizing their opponents. How do you think the Netherlands is going to answer back against this squad?
Well, I don't know. It's a matter of them having to show up today. I mean, they have to come bring the best game that they can bring to take down Complexity. I mean, it takes a lot of team coordination, too. Complexity is one of those teams, when you watch their play style, Puckett, they're going to actually have, you know, this coordination that no other team I've seen has. They're going to break your setups by working together. They're going to wait for each other to move across the map. And that's what makes them better than most teams out there. So it should be interesting to see how that goes down. And you and I are both kind of looking over at the side station right now. The action is getting fierce on the other streams also. We just heard some screaming going on. So definitely some good gameplay going on here at Call of Duty Championship presented by Xbox.
Yeah, you know, that was an Orbitz match that was getting heated up over there. It looked like a little bit of trash talk going on our side broadcast. Remember, guys, you are just watching the Alpha broadcast here on the Xbox main stage, but we also have our Bravo broadcast, Charlie broadcast, and Delta broadcast simultaneously going on four different groups on all of those streams.
And now you're seeing all these camera angles inside the Octagon on the main stage there. Beautiful, beautiful main stage here at Call of Duty Championship. And there you see both of our teams getting ready to start this matchup, just getting everything set, ready to go. You see our officials in the booth with them, making sure everything's ready. And that is indoors, so beautiful.
Pretty awesome. And Hastro, I gotta ask you here. So every single game mode requires a very specific class. You're going to have different loadouts that are going to be more advantageous. In Domination, very fast-paced game mode, three different objectives to focus on. What are some of the key class setups that we'll be seeing from our pro players?
Yeah, it's variable depending on the game mode, and that's something that you're going to see a little bit of downtime in between the rounds, because the players aren't going to use the same classes for every game mode, right? So, you know, Ghost gives you this crazy amount of customization. So a lot of these guys are going to be switching all sorts of things, and a lot of these guys have actually been studying their opponents as well. I wouldn't be surprised if Complexity put a book together on the players that they're about to face, right? So they might say, okay, Black, he's known for playing that slow SMG, or slow AR. How are we going to counter that? Can we use smokes to kind of take him out of his position and make him move?
Right.
You know, so, and I think that's what you have to pay attention to. You and I are going to have to do a good job of kind of explaining that to everyone out there, because it's really hard to pick up on that sometimes. There's so many things that these players are going to be using.
Iggs, for example, has five classes. He, out of the 10 that he normally plays with online, five of them just have one minor change, and that's either going from smokes to concussions, switching up the reticles that he's going to be using, whether he's going to be using a hybrid sight on his Remington, all kinds of different classes, but those smallest changes can totally change the way that he's going to be able to not only help his team, but affect the opponent.
Yeah, and Search and Destroy is probably what we're going to see the most variation in, depending on how you're playing, let's say, a certain offense. If you have to plant the bomb on offense, whether you're going A or B, what kind of equipment do you need? What kind of tacticals do you take? Do you take two frags? Do you take one frag? Do you leave no frags in your class? Depending on your position on that map, what you're trying to accomplish, S&D is that game mode where we're going to see a lot of class variation. In the other run and gun game modes, it's pretty standard. You know, you pick one class and you kind of run and gun with it. And depending on your setup on that map, you know, maybe you switch to another one. But I look for those classes to change a lot in Search and Destroy.
All right, well, our first game mode is going to be Domination. Our first map is going to be Octane. We're gearing up for game number one. Stro, this map plays to both SMGs and ARs. What is the secret to success on Domination? Because you know B's right out there in the center of the map, definitely the most highly contested flag.
Yeah, Octane is a great map for ARs. Whenever you get your AR set up around that B flag, especially in some of the cutoffs for some of the spawn points, look for your AR players to dominate and maintain those flag positions for your team. A two-flag setup, including that B flag, is always so crucial, and a good way to kind of move that over to the next flag is to just kind of push over off your spawn and overextend for the team that needs the advantage.
Well, here we go. Action already underway. We're jumping on board with Aches, the captain of Complexity. Already Karma, Aches in the kill feed, and Aches has control of top Broken, and this is really considered a power position on this map.
Yeah, and you see immediately Complexity are so good at this. They rush the B flag right off the break. They pick that up, and here they are sitting with a two-flag setup. And just like I said, Puckett, the ARs dominate the setup here. So Aches sitting up top Broken right there with an AR, and he's locking down the map. He doesn't need to move at all right now. And meanwhile, you see that they're already pushing a three-cap.
Wow.
Crimsix already in the spawn there for real All-Stars.
And TP and friends continue pushing up. TP's going to move through the middle. Aches, of course, will watch anything on the far right. Meanwhile, you're going to see, it looks like Krim also coming off that respawn to help out Aches now. Is he really going to move up? Yeah, he's giving up his power position. He wants to pinch in too. What's the game plan here from these guys?
It just looks like it's a little rotation game coming out of Complexity early on, but you see a player for Fariko All-Stars is pushing that flag now. He's trying to get around Complexity, and he managed to do that. So Complexity is losing their home flag now, but nonetheless, you see Black is taking that flag. There
Uh-oh.
Is a player for Complexity
Not in
right
time.
There, and Complexity now flips it on them as well. So now Complexity is in a great spot to get this three cap, and it looks like Aches is going to get it.
Yeah, Aches got C back in their favor. Meanwhile, you're going to see TP pushed up in the middle of the map. He's got some teammates to work with there as Karma also on that B flag, and Aches right up top again. Top Broken here. He's going to do some serious damage. Three players in sight. Can he hit them all? He's tagged them all up. Where's the help? He won't be able to finish it out. TP, though, comes in with the MTAR.
Oh, and TP's going to get a big three-piece right here if he continues to go at it. He decides to back off. His teammate picks up the kill there as well. And now you see just Complexity rolling away with this one. This is 51-7. They are just performing at a high level right now. For Fariko All-Stars, they really have to get their heads in the game really quickly before they let it go.
Complexity saying he thinks strictly business is good. Wait till we show you what we bring to the table. Already 8 kills for TP, 8 kills for Crimsix, 8 kills for Karma, and we're going back to Big Krim. Krimbot set up on this right side. considered one of the most accurate players in the game.
Yeah, and you see Krim, you know, like I said, the ARs. Just when you have a two flag set up here and you get a cross with two ARs, it's almost impossible to break that against a team like Complexity. So you really have to come off the break hot, and they didn't do that. Frigo All-Stars did not manage to come off the break and pick up that early B flag, and that's really punishing them right now.
Krim 6 set up behind the Humvee, and this is a dangerous spot to be in if you are this All-Stars lineup. It looks like Krim is now going to push into C, actually, while everyone else is distracted over at A by Aches and Teepee. Looks like we're going to see Krim easily grab this C flag. Let's switch over while Krim is grabbing C to see what Aches is doing to pinch in his opponents.
And Aches is just playing a patient game right now. Great job by him picking up one, but he gets a trade there. He gets taken down. And now you see Teepee just putting some shots in. This Complexity team right now is just ruthless against the Frico, or sorry, against the real All-Stars. And it's just really, really tough for them to break a setup right here. But now you see three players for Complexity go down, all four down for Complexity. And now you see the urgency to get to that B flag. Can they manage to pick this up?
Looks like Bisaru was distracting over at C. He goes down. Daredevil, though, grabs B, gets the kill as well. So one down for Cole. Two more players up, pushing through gas. The third is on C. That's Teepee with the capture. Daredevil knows he's got to get in here, and he's got to win this one-on-one. Big kill there.
Oh, and almost a two-piece there for Daredevil, but he gets taken down. That was Karma picking up the kill onto Daredevil. And now two players down for the real All-Stars. Complexity managing to get a little bit of a coordination going on. You see them kind of threatening the middle of the map. One player for Complexity pushing that flag on the A side, and he is bumping that flag, which I like, but he does go down. That was Teepee kind of trying to stretch out.
Meanwhile, Karma's going for B. He's going to be cleaned up as well. So nice rotation here by All-Stars. Bisaru now protecting this back C flag. Two more players pushing up. Bissell pushing out, and he's got it. Two more players, though. Can he get this next kill, Hashtro?
Oh, that was a big kill by Bissell, and almost picks up another one right there. Great job by All-Stars bringing that back a little bit, but still, Puckett,
40 Complexity points, man.
Was so dominant in the first 3 minutes of this round that All-Stars really are behind by a ton. And even though they showed some signs of life near the end of this round, it just wasn't enough to bring them back in a realistic scenario of winning this map. We're going,
I don't
to,
a, know, man.
We're
I've going seen to a second deficits.
Half. I have too. But like I said, realistically, it's really tough for them to come back from this. We can never count them out.
33 points. That's all it is. 33 points. It was 50 at one point.
I'm with you here. As a caster, I never, ever, ever want to count a team out. And I'm not doing that right now. But at the same time, the way Complexity came off with that hot start, it's going to take a three cap here out of these guys from the All-Stars to actually kind of roll back through and steamroll their way into it. Complexity's just such a tough team to do that to.
Man, Complexity's got to be proud of those first 3 minutes, but a little bit worried about what happened in that final one. We did see some nice rotations, but in the end, no one above 8 kills. Torres had the most kills on that side. That is equal to Aches, who had the least kills for Complexity, and he was simply not getting kills because he was staying back. Teepee, 14-8. 14-6 for Krim 6, and the reigning champion, Karma, who won the world title for Black Ops 2, 13-8.
Yeah, and that's something to talk about too. Karma, the only player here at Call of Duty Championships that can actually defend the title. So he's the only sole player who can be a back-to-back Call of Duty World Champion,
yeah,
if he manages to win this title. So you know he wants that.
And there we see the game getting started up. We'll go at it for 5 more minutes. Remember, that deficit is going to carry over to the second side. A 33-point bonus here for Complexity. All they got to do is keep this game close. They cannot let the All-Stars pull away early on.
Yeah, I know you just saw Black on your screen talking to his teammates. You know he's trying to figure out what they can do here to pick up those 35 points. And Teepee on the other side also chatting with his teammates. Now you see both teams on your screen. Definitely some strategy being talked right now, Puckett. You know, I can't exactly hear what they're saying, but they are definitely chatting it up, trying to figure out what they can both do to solidify this first map.
Well, I mean, Complexity's first push was just incredible. They had their opponents pinned before the game began, but now they're switching sides. I want to see what can they do from the motel side of the map. And at the start, I'm going to show you the mini map in full as we see how will they get this one started.
Yeah, like I said, I did not want to knock the fact that All-Stars can't come back here. You know, I didn't want to stress that because they absolutely can. It's just going to take everything they have against a team like Complexity. What they did at the end of that round was amazing, though. They managed to almost get a three cap. They had the third flag contested, and they were racking up a lot of points. If they can continue that here, just right off the break, then they're going to have a great shot of actually taking this first half.
Ix getting right into the action. Look at this start. He will go down. TP, though, was able to sneak in gas, and now TP's behind enemy lines already. They have A control. B, they're going to leave totally contested, while TP so sneakily is going to come back to C. That's going to force All-Stars to double back. In fact, he's not going for the objective yet. He's going to try and pick up a kill first.
He's actually waiting for his teammates to pick up the kills in the feed. And there you see Aches does pick up one. TP decides to go ahead and go for it now. And then you see Complexity just kind of jump on all of the maps, or at least have a position on all of the maps or on all the flags. And now you see TP picking up big kills.
Already, man.
And you see that. Like I said, Complexity so good at coordinating as a team. They coordinated that perfectly, synced up. Everybody went for a flag when they needed to. And look at this. Crypsix, easy kills here on the C flag for him. They managed to get that, All-Stars did, but look at this. They're going to cap it right back.
Ix came on the flank, man. He came right behind everyone. Got to the two-piece. You saw the one from Krim, and now Krim, he's just going to bounce back and forth from top. Broken, finally cleaned up. Let's go over. Do you want to watch Karma? We haven't shown this man much so far.
Yeah, we should definitely spectate Karma picking up a kill there with the thermal sight.
Double.
Make that two. And now Karma is just lingering around this B flag, being a nuisance. He's actually going to go for it right here. Looking for some cover from his teammates. Great grenade coming out from the All-Stars, though, to take Karma off that B flag.
Definitely a desperation grenade coming in there by Daredevil. But Eggs comes up top, cleans up that kill on Torres. Will get shut down on the back of the base. Meanwhile, you're going to have, guess who? TP, the master objective player, sneaking in the back one more time. He's going to go contest C, while All-Stars, they wanted to go for B. Now they're forced to double back.
Oh, look at this grenade that TP just threw. He closed the door, gets the hit marker. But that player did come through and take out TP. That was Bissell from the All-Star squad. And now Crimson set up over here at the blue bin once again. Great spot right there on this map to watch that B cross, and now Crimson is going to make a nice little jump move over here towards top pawn shop, but he gets taken down from top hotel, and that is going to be All-Stars making a push here.
Visceru in a key position. He's got to get this double kill. Can't get it. Shut down again. Guess who? It's the Captain Ix, who's not done yet.
And Aches, yeah, in the middle of the map, patrolling that B flag, making sure they don't lose that. And Complexity making a case for themselves right now. They're in the lead by quite a bit again on the second side. Puckett adding to that deficit for the All-Stars. And you see Crimson again just playing his patient game right now on the outskirts of that B side of the map, right? Middle of the map, playing the outskirts with that AR. Very deadly from Crimson.
And Krim knows, hey, I'm going to go do a TP move. I'm going to go touch this C flag. I got that kill. No problem. Aegis is getting kills in the middle of the map. I have TP lit up as well as that yellow arrow, so you can just watch the rotation. If you're trying to get better at Call of Duty, I would highly suggest just watching Complexity's minimap in the top left. Where are those blue arrows going? Because they have such fantastic communication, always spread out, and always in a position to stop an opponent from getting on their objective.
Yeah, and that's what you're exactly right, Puckett. If you want to get better at Call of Duty as a team, watch Complexity. Get your team together and watch them play and talk about the rotations that they make and how they coordinate their movements around the map. That's the best thing that you can do to get better, is watch a team like them play with your teammates.
Learn from these guys, and there's another example. Karma's like, you can also get a three-piece and look awesome doing it. I only got two. The third one got away, and oh, came out and shut him down. But the score totally out of hand now, 75-28. That's the second half. Add on the 33-point bonus from the start, and this is a complete blowout from Complexity.
Yeah, they look strong, Puckett, looking like the team that we know they are. And right now, they're not faltering one bit, putting up the scoreboard. And you see 50-point lead right now for them on this second side. Add that to the 35 they've already put up. It's mathematically impossible for All-Stars to come back now. Now it's just showtime. Let's spectate Karma, because he's always a bit
Karma?
Of a showman. Yeah.
All right, 1 second. I had to show Torres, because he was struggling. He was 3-10 for a while. Did go on a 3-kill spree, but here's Karma. You asked for him. He's showing off his gaunt skill. Takes down Black. Torres, the last man standing. They know they're coming off the respawn back at C. Karma just setting up to get these front pawn kills.
Yeah, there's not enough you can say about this guy as a Slayer. Karma always lights up the scoreboard, and when, like I said, when he gets hot, he's unstoppable, and sometimes he makes the most insane plays. So if we're going to catch one, he's probably our best bet.
Karma is just simply playing his role. Meanwhile,
it's coming, though.
Krim 6 has it locked down on the left side. There's one for Karma. Second one in the middle. Tags him up. Going to leave that for Krim. Gets the kill top on. No, he's taken down. Krim 6, though, in position to answer back. Gets one, looking for the pawn player. There he is. Big kill on Fizzle, and there's a three-piece for Krim.
And you just see Complexity having a great time right now. The ARs are firing for them. You see Remingtons all over the map for Complexity as they take map number one domination over the Real All-Stars here at the Call of Duty Championship presented by Xbox.
Nice work from Krim. Gets the three-piece in the kill feed, 17-6, locking down that entire left lane. Complexity. I had them coming in this tournament, just to be honest with everyone. I said, this is the team to watch. I have them going all the way, winning this championship title. I know how hungry they are, and they are just putting on a show, showing that they are four of the best players in the game when it comes to slaying. You add that to their objective mastermind strategies, and this squad is going to be so tough to beat.
Oh, I agree 100% with you. I mean, if you have to put your money on a team, you'd probably want to put it on Complexity here, especially with this being the largest tournament of their careers, and it's hard to bet against them.
All right, well, All-Stars fell short last year in Black Ops 2. You know they want to bounce back and get to group play, but first, let's take a look at the replays from our game number one in the first side of domination. It was a show from Complexity. Bisru failed to get the two-piece, was unable to get B control, and from there, Krim 6 in the back, getting behind enemy lines with TP all game long. They got the three cap from this one, and they just did not let off that gas pedal, continued to crush in the slaying columns.
Yeah, and there you see Karma here towards the end of the round, hovering around that B flag. He's three players coming around his right, picks up that big two-piece, and then gets some nice shots in there. Couldn't get that third one, but didn't really matter at that point. Now Krim 6 up top broken here, picks up a big kill, just says, come on, come challenge me. Don't even go for the
flag.
And
here he is at the end, the three-piece. Gets two, looking for the third, and he will be challenged. Does he find it? We missed it at the start. Doesn't matter. He got it the first time when we were alive. Fantastic opening here for Complexity. They are now up one game, taking the first and the best of five.